on the topic of cross-disciplinary bridges, please welcome, from the Harvard MIT MD-PhD program, class of 2019, Rachel Wolfson.
Hi, I'm Rachel. As an MD-PhD student in my final year in the program, I am thrilled that in a few short months, I will be on the wards rounding as a resident physician. But my journey to biomedical science began in a place very far from bedside interactions in the hospital. It began with this. I started my undergraduate career at Stanford as a math major. I spent most of my freshman year in the basement of the math building, sweating over proofs like this one. It was intellectually stimulating, and it offered a sense of accomplishment. And yet, for me, something was missing. Then I met Calvin Kuo, a physician scientist at Stanford. I started both working in his lab, studying cancer genetics, and also shadowing him in oncology clinic. I found that working on complex problems in the lab that were inspired by our patients in the clinic was the perfect combination for me. Math was no longer my calling. I had found medicine. As I started the MD-PhD program here, I found a new proof to solve, one with a deeply human impact, the feeding habits of cancer cells. How do tumor cells sense nutrients in their environment and decide whether to grow based on that information? Do they do that in a way that's different from regular cells? I looked for answers in the lab of David Sabatini at MIT. For 4 years, I sat here. It may not look like much to you, but to me, it was the perfect refuge to be singularly focused on studying this protein. At first, we knew nothing about it. But after years of pipetting, testing, analyses, discussions, and many failed experiments, we uncovered valuable clues. We learned that sestrin-2 acts as the direct sensor of an important nutrient and allows cells, both cancer cells and regular cells, to grow when that nutrient is available. This seemingly tiny breakthrough opened up a world of possibilities. What if we could find a way to alter this protein? What if we could target this protein with small molecules that changed its behavior? If we succeeded, we could alter the outcomes of a range of diseases, things like epilepsy, muscle atrophy, and cancer. I kept thinking about sestrin-2, this tiny sensor protein, and the possibilities that it represented. In my third year of medical school, I started to think about how we, as organisms, sense nutrients in our environment. This sparked my interest in studying the sensory neurons in the gastrointestinal tract. What role might they play in enabling us, as humans, to sense our environment? And how might this be dysregulated in human disease? The answers to these questions could yield insights into everything from how we sense hunger and satiety to how we feel pain. That brought me to David Ginty, whose lab is focused on understanding the neural circuits that underlie the sense of touch. I told him he probably wouldn't be interested in the questions that I was asking. His response, try me. I'm now working in the Ginty lab, trying to identify molecular markers of neurons that innervate the colon, which we believe are essential for sensing distinct types of pain. This may help us target various causes of abdominal pain, such as colitis, inflammatory bowel disease, and many others. So here I am, just a few months shy of my residency, to be followed, I hope, by a fellowship in gastroenterology, still using the problem-solving skills that I developed in a math classroom, but now to approach the problems of human health. I have been very fortunate throughout my time at Harvard Medical School to find daring mentors who are willing to take a chance on my imagination. It is not the knowledge that we have, but the audacity to apply that knowledge in new and creative ways that sets Harvard Medical School apart. This reminds me of a quote. Imagination is more important than knowledge, for knowledge is limited, whereas imagination embraces the entire world, stimulating progress, giving birth to evolution. As I stand here with you today, I think about the imagination of the HMS community. I think about my small discovery that opened a world of possibilities, and I multiply that by the number of students, postdocs, clinicians, and scientists across Harvard Medical School. And I can easily see the impact that our imagination can have on transforming the future of human health. Thank you.